What we really try to encourage families and primary care doctors to watch for is morning stiffness. So stiffness in the morning after a child lays in bed all night, that arthritis gets very stiff. So they get up, they start to limp, and it takes a while to loosen up. So early morning stiffness, limping in the morning, limping after naps, long car rides is very useful. And then joint swelling. If the joint's swollen, that usually indicates the chance that there's an arthritis. One of the most challenging diagnoses are the very young children because they can't communicate. So it really requires having the parents see something that's changed. Often we'll see that it's a child that went from their toddler type gait or crawling to now wanting to be carried, or going from walking to back to crawling. So they stop using the joints that they used to use, or they go from someone who was more of a right hand dominant to more of a left hand. So they start to favor using the other hand. So they don't want to use the hand that's a little bit stiff or sore. And then I think the other part is just looking for the symptoms that a child seems to get better as the day goes on. They get up, they start moving around, they start crawling, and they seem to look a little bit better. But then after their nap or in the morning, they just look kind of slow, hard to move, kind of more cranky. And that's just a sign that it has that stiffness. When we approach a child with juvenile arthritis, our goal really is to try to achieve a clinical remission, meaning inactive disease. And our first goal would be to target the arthritis with whatever medications we can to get it in a remission on medications. And then over time, if we maintain that remission on those medications, then we slowly pull those medications back off to see if they maintain that remission. The most common form of arthritis, the oligoarthritis subset, which is the one that only has a few joints, a large percentage of patients can enter a lasting remission off meds. The other forms of arthritis, we still try to get to that point where the remission's maintained off meds, but a lot of patients do need long-term medication. However, they can control their arthritis and not have active arthritis, which again is the goal. It just requires more duration of their medications.